In this video, I'd like to talk about utilizing stock models in a way that's not conventionally thought about in Mastercam. Typically, when we talk about stock models, we're using them to optimize roughing operations in order to add some stock intelligence and minimize air cuts. However, in this example, I want to talk about using them with finishing operations. Not many Mastercam users know that you can utilize stock models with the 3D HST finishing toolpaths. First, I want to start by doing a verification to familiarize us with the part. This file is already set up with a roughing toolpath, followed by a stock model, and then a waterline finishing toolpath. Navigating to the Verify options, I'll turn on Stock Model, and then in the dropdown, I'll pick the stock model called 1. Now hit OK, and then launch Verify for operation number 3, the waterline finish pass. Let's run all the way through the verification process. In the Verify tab at the top, turn on the Compare Utility. I'll hit the green regenerate arrows in the panel on the right side, and this gives me a color-coded visual for how much material is left on the part. Notice the dark blue in the very corner, which signifies a significant amount of stock left. This is due to the tool being too large. This is a pretty typical issue on 3D pockets. The walls are right at finish with zero stock left, but in the corners, we're still leaving a lot of stock. Back in Mastercam, I'm going to copy that stock model below the waterline toolpath with a right click and drag. I'll go into the parameters, and here you will notice a new feature for Mastercam 2021. The stock models now auto-rename and increment. A minor upgrade, but it certainly makes it much easier when creating or copying stock models. For the initial stock shape, I'm going to turn on stock model and point it to the prior stock model, number 1. Under the source operations, I want this stock model to reference that previous waterline in operation 3. And it's always important when using stock models to be aware of your tolerances. They should always be as loose as they can be while still best reflecting where the stock is and where there is air for optimal regeneration. Oftentimes, the default tolerances are overly tight, especially when working with large complex parts and tools. In this case, I'll double the values. You'd be surprised how large an effect this can have on file size, especially as it gets compounded with multiple stock models. Click OK and regenerate. Next, I'll copy the waterline toolpath after this stock model. I'll go into the waterline parameters and select this 6mm ball end mill under the tool tab. From here, I'll head over to the stock tab. I'll turn on the trim to stock checkbox and I'll look at one other operation. In the right side panel, I'll select the newly created stock model. Hit OK. After regen, you'll now notice that the new stock-aware waterline trims a lot of the toolpath out, but we're still getting some residual toolpath in different areas where the tool doesn't necessarily need to be. This is due to the tolerances of the stock model and the toolpath, as it's recognizing some material left on the part. How can we get rid of this and focus the toolpath just in one specific area? To achieve this, I'm going to create a stock model in a very unconventional way. I'm going to go to the Surfaces tab, click on the Surfaces from Solid, and then select these four fillets in the corners, and then end the selection. Relaunch the parameters from that stock model that we previously created. Here's where things get a little different. Underneath the initial stock shape, I'm going to use the model selection and grab these four surfaces that I just created. Under the additional offset field, I can enter 2 millimeters. This is going to thicken up the surfaces with stock. Hit OK, and after regenerating, let's take a look. Although this doesn't reflect the real stock, this false stock will help us squeeze every bit of efficiency from the toolpath and allow even more finite control. With the new stock model, now I can regenerate that waterline toolpath. Remember that it's still tied to and dependent on the updated stock. We can now see that we have no more wasted motion. This stock model forces the toolpath to focus all the motion only in the corners just as originally desired. One powerful piece of functionality with this method comes into play if I wanted to blend this toolpath entry and exit a little further out from the corners. To do this, just reopen the stock model parameters, set the additional offset to 6 millimeter, and then regen both the stock model and the waterline toolpath. Look at how easy it is to control the toolpath overlap onto our already finished surfaces. I hope this unique way of looking at stock models and 3D HST toolpaths was thought-provoking. Maybe after watching this, you too can start leveraging the power of stock awareness in more than just roughing applications. Applying stock to finishing toolpaths can improve efficiency, reduce air cuts, and really step up your game as a Mastercam programmer, especially when it comes to complex 3D surfaces.